students, today we are going to study one new theorem. The statement is if G is a graph on P vertices, then we are going to prove these two inequalities. The first inequality is 2 root P less than or equal to psi of G plus psi of G complement, which is less than or equal to P plus P. Here we used one notation, namely G complement, which is nothing but complement of the graph G. So we know what is a complement of a graph. That complement of a graph contains all the vertices of the graph G and the vertices which are non-adjacent in G should be adjacent in G complement. That is the definition of G complement. So, in the second inequality, we are going to prove this one. So, as usual, we are assuming the hypothesis. Let G be a graph on P vertices. So, we selected one graph with P vertices. First, we are going to prove this part, that is P is less than or equal to psi of G into psi of G complement. That part we are going to prove first. So for that, we are assuming psi of G equal to K. That is, for this graph G, to color the vertices of G, we need K colors. So there exists a K coloring of G. That means the vertex set of G can be partitioned into K subsets, namely V1, V2, etc., Vk. That is, this V1 is set of all vertices of G which receives color 1, and V2 is set of all vertices of G which receive color 2, and so on. So obviously the vertices in Vi, where I varies from 1 to k, are non-adjacent, because these are all vertices which receives the same color, and hence they should be non-adjacent. Now we are going to find the cardinality of each set, cardinality of V1, cardinality of V2, up to cardinality of Vk we are considering. So among these cardinality, we are going to choose the maximum value, and that value is denoted by T. Okay, so T equal to maximum of cardinality of Vi. So obviously this G complement contains KT as a subgraph. Since these Vi's are collection of all vertices which are non-adjacent in G, therefore they must be adjacent in G complement. And this T is the maximum value of cardinality of Vi, and so obviously this G complement contains KT as a subgraph. For example, suppose we are considering this graph. So here we have 4 vertices, namely V1, V2, V3 and V4. Suppose V1 is assigned by color B, then obviously this vertex V2 is assigned by another color R. Since this V2 is adjacent, V3 is adjacent to both V1 and V2, we can't use B and R for V3. So one more color G is selected here, and for V4 we can choose this R itself. So totally 3 colors required to color this graph. So psi of G equal to 3 here. So now I am going to collect VB, that is set of vertices which receive color B. So obviously this is V1, so cardinality is 1, and VR cardinality is 2, and VG cardinality is also 1. So among these cardinality, we are going to find the maximum value. So that value is here 2. So for this graph, our G complement is nothing but collection of all the vertices of G. So totally we have this V1, V2, V3 and V4 and set of vertices which are non-adjacent in G should be adjacent in G complement. So here V2 and V4 are non-adjacent. Therefore, this V2 and V4 is adjacent in this G complement. So this is our G complement. So this G complement contains K2. So this is K2, isn't it? So obviously all the G complement contains this KT. Okay, so that is a well known result. So this KT is here, that is a complete graph with the T vertices is here, subgraph of G complement. Therefore, by result, so we know if G is a graph and H is a subgraph, then psi of G is always greater than or equal to psi of H. So previously we studied this result, no? So using that result, we have psi of G complement is greater than or equal to psi of KT, since KT is a subgraph of G complement. Okay, next from this we know psi of KT, that is complete graph chromatic number with T vertices always equal to T. So we have psi of G complement is greater than or equal to T. And that T value is obviously greater than or equal to P by K. Okay, so why means this G has P vertices and all these P vertices are splitted into K subsets. So obviously the maximum set should be greater than or equal to P by K value. For example, if we have 100 rupees and we have to distribute this one to 5 persons not equally, then the maximum amount should be distributed will be 12, more than 20. So using that concept, we can tell this T should be greater than or equal to P by K. From this, we are taking these two terms. Then we have psi of G complement is greater than or equal to P by K. So from this, we get psi of G complement into K is greater than or equal to K. But K is nothing but psi of G. Therefore, we get psi of G into psi of G complement is greater than or equal to P. Okay, so first inequality is proved. So next we are going to prove this one, psi of G plus psi of G complement is greater than or equal to 2 root P. So that inequality we are going to prove. So this is one simple calculation, we can derive this inequality. So obviously arithmetic mean is greater than or equal to geometric mean. It is a well known result. Now we are going to find arithmetic mean and geometric mean for these two terms. Our terms are psi of G and then psi of G complement. For these two terms, we are going to define this arithmetic mean and geometric mean. So obviously arithmetic mean is psi of G plus psi of G complement divided by 2, and the geometric mean for this term is psi of G into psi of G complement the whole power 1 by 2. So using this concept, these two are greater than or equal to, but we proved from equation 1 this is greater than or equal to P power 1 by 2. So from this we can conclude psi of G plus psi of G complement is greater than or equal to 2 root P. Okay, so up to this we completed this part and this one. Okay, so these two are proved. So now we are going to prove this result, that is psi of G plus psi of G complement is less than or equal to P plus 1. So that inequality we are going to prove. So as usual, we are going to prove this result using induction. We are going to prove this inequality by induction on P. First, we are assuming P equal to 1. So P is 1 means it contains only one vertex. So obviously our graph G is with one vertex. Therefore psi of G value is 1. Then psi of G complement is also 1 because G complement also has only this vertex alone. So chromatic number for this vertex is 1. So we get psi of G complement is also 1. So now we are considering psi of G plus psi of G complement, which is 1 plus 1, and 1 is nothing but P here. So we get this value is equal to P plus 1. So we proved psi of G plus psi of G complement, which is equal to P plus 1. So when P equal to 1, we proved this inequality. So the result is true for P equal to 1. As usual, we are going to assume the result is true for all graph with P minus 1 vertices. That is, if H is a graph which contains P minus 1 vertices, then we are going to assume psi of H plus psi of H complement, that is less than or equal to P minus 1 plus 1. So that assumption is assumed here. So we get psi of H plus psi of H complement is less than or equal to P when H is a graph with P minus 1 vertices. So this assumption is assumed in this stage. So next our aim is to prove the result for P vertices. So we are considering one graph. So let G be a graph on P vertices. So we have to prove psi of G plus psi of G complement should be less than or equal to P plus 1. So our result is true for P minus 1 vertices. Now we have a graph with P vertices. So if we delete a vertex from this graph G, then the resulting graph has only P minus 1 vertices. For that graph, we can apply our induction hypothesis. So based on this concept, we are selecting one vertex B as an arbitrary vertex in G, and delete the vertex B and consider the graph G difference B. Then obviously G difference B consisting of only P minus 1 vertices. So this is G difference V is a graph with P minus 1 vertices. Hence by induction hypothesis we have psi of G difference V plus psi of G difference V the whole complement should be less than or equal to P minus 1 plus 1. That minus 1 and plus 1 getting cancelled, so we have less than or equal to P. Okay. But for any graph G, we have this inequality. This is a trivial inequality, namely psi of G difference V less than or equal to psi of G, which is less than or equal to psi of G difference V plus 1. Reason for this is always G difference V is a subgraph of G. So we have psi of G difference V should be less than or equal to psi of G, and that value is trivially less than or equal to this term, namely psi of G difference V plus 1. So by simple calculation we can verify this inequality. Similarly, for the graph G complement also, we can write this inequality. So for that graph, we have psi of G complement difference V, which is less than or equal to psi of G complement, that is less than or equal to psi of G complement difference V plus 1. Okay. So these results are written for two graphs, namely one is G and another one is G complement. So these two inequalities are very basic and trivial inequality. We can verify with any graph. Okay. So from this we can tell two terms. One is psi of g difference v equal to psi of g. Another one we can tell psi of g equal to psi of g difference v plus one. Similarly, two terms we can consider from this inequality also. So these terms are considered as two cases. First we are considering case 1. So in this case 1 we are considering psi of g equal to this one, psi of g equal to psi of g difference v, or the second, from the second inequality we can consider psi of g complement equal to psi of g complement difference v. So these two terms are considered in first case. So for our definiteness, we are assuming psi of g equal to psi of g difference v. Either this one or this one is assumed. So we are considering this one as the confirmed result, that is psi of g equal to psi of g difference v we are assuming. So now we are considering psi of g plus psi of g complement. Here psi of g is replaced by psi of g difference v, and psi of g complement is replaced by this one, which is less than or equal to psi of g complement difference v plus 1. So for this term we are replacing less than or equal to. So this equality, so we are putting less than or equal to symbol here. But always g complement difference v is equal to g difference v the whole complement. Therefore this term is replaced by psi of g difference v the whole complement. So using our induction hypothesis, so here we assume the psi of g difference v plus psi of g difference v the whole complement is less than or equal to p naught. So that assumption is carried over here. So we get this inequality, this term is less than or equal to p. Up to this we are replacing p and then plus 1. So we have psi of g plus psi of g complement is less than or equal to p plus 1. So our result is proved when psi of g difference v equal to psi of g, or psi of g complement difference v equal to psi of g complement. So similarly we can assume this result also, we get the same thing. So our assumption is requirement is fulfilled when this case is considered. Okay, so next we are moving to the other case, namely psi of g equal to psi of g difference v plus 1 and psi of g complement equal to psi of g complement difference v plus 1. So that term is assumed here. Okay. Previously we studied one result, that is in our previous video we studied one result. So statement of that result is like this. If we see a vertex in a graph G such that psi of G equal to psi of G difference V plus 1, then degree of v in the graph g should be greater than or equal to psi of g difference v. So we proved this result in our previous section. So here also we have psi of g equal to psi of g difference v plus 1, that is hypothesis of this theorem is fulfilled for this graph g. So we get a degree of v in the graph g should be greater than or equal to psi of g difference v. Similarly, psi of g complement equal to psi of g complement difference v plus 1. So for the graph g complement, we get degree of B in the graph G complement should be greater than or equal to psi of G complement difference. We use that theorem. Okay. So now, as usual, we are considering this term psi of G plus psi of G complement. So psi of G is replaced by psi of G difference B plus 1, and psi of G complement is replaced by psi of G complement difference B plus 1. Okay. And solving this one, we get this equation. And psi of g difference v is less than or equal to degree of v plus g. So this one is replaced by less than or equal to degree of v in the graph g, and this is replaced by degree of v in the graph g complement. So here we have degree sum of degree of a vertex v in both the graph g as well as g complement, so which is obviously equal to p minus 1, that is the vertex which are adjacent to the vertices which are adjacent to v in g. Similarly, the vertices which are adjacent to v in g complement is considered. Sum of these values obviously equal to p minus 1. With that we have 1 plus 2, so totally we get this is p plus 1. Okay, so here also we proved psi of g plus psi of g complement is less than or equal to p plus 1. So by induction hypothesis, the result is true for any integer value, any natural number. Okay, so totally we have psi of g. So psi of g plus psi of g complement less than or equal to p plus 1. So that is proved. As usual, the arithmetic mean is always greater than or equal to geometric mean. So that concept is used, and by simple calculation we can prove psi of g into psi of g complement less than or equal to p plus 1 the whole squared divided by 4. So combining all these inequality, we required our result. So this is the proof of this theorem.